The lathe has the ability to cut tapers with work being held between the chuck and the tailstock by setting the tailstock off of center. If you notice, there is a scale on the tailstock. When I want to cut work that is the same diameter, in other words, not tapered, this needs to be in line. If I want to cut tapers, it comes out of line and the top of the casting will actually move off of center. This is accomplished by tightening and loosening two set screws, one in the front and one in the opposite position in the back. This is not done often anymore because of taper attachments that are on most lathes, and this can be a real problem if this tailstock is off of center, because if you want to turn work parallel, sometimes it's an issue and it tapers. So I'm going to show you how to set it back to zero today. Material up in a three-jaw chuck, and I'm holding it in the tailstock with a revolving center. The tailstock is locked to the way of the lathe, and the spindle of the tailstock is locked. I have a turning tool set up, and I'm going to cut two small pads or diameters, one towards the tailstock and one towards the headstock, and all I need is just enough length to be able to get a micrometer on it. The trick is I'm going to come in on the same diameter or the same spot on my cross slide. Set to zero. Just going to cut a length that I can get to micrometer on. I'm going to back my cross slide off one revolution. I'm going to come up to the chuck, and I'm going to go in one revolution. Touches the work, I'm going to come into the same zero. Engage the feed. All right. Okay, we're ready to take a measurement at the tailstock and at the headstock. So at the tailstock, the micrometer is 975 thou. And at the headstock, the size is 993 thou, so a difference of about 18 thou. The headstock is actually larger than the tailstock, so what it tells me is the tailstock is sitting too close to the camera or too close to the front of the lathe. So what we need to do is we need to adjust the tailstock back half of that distance, which should be about 9 thou. Okay, I've set a dial indicator up on the side of the tailstock, and I have it perpendicular to the side of the tailstock, so we'll get a true reading on the dial indicator. Please notice if I pull the needle towards me, it goes in a clockwise direction. Because it's a bit larger in diameter at the tailstock, we want the tailstock to go away from us, or we want it to go counterclockwise. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set zero on the tailstock, and we're going to have the needle move counterclockwise half of the difference in diameter. Because it was 18 thou, we're going to actually move it about 9 thou. Now, if you have trouble moving it by adjusting this Allen key in the set screw front and back, there may be a third set screw underneath the back that is locking it in place, so you'll need to loosen that one first. Okay, so here we are, we're ready to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to loosen the set screw in the back, and I want that needle to move in a counterclockwise direction, and it's going the wrong way. So we'll loosen the one in the back, and you can see it starting to move, and we'll tighten the one in the front and hopefully get the result we want. So there's that 9 thou, and I'm going to tighten the one in the back, and hopefully this solves our taper issue. Alrighty, we're going to make sure everything's nice and tight, and we'll go back and take another cut off of the part. Okay, so now we're ready to take a measurement. We'll take a measurement at the headstock end, and we're at about 967. We'll take a measurement down at the tailstock end, and we're getting about the same reading, out about a 1 thou. So we may have to do a little bit more adjustment, but you get an idea how this is done. Okay, let's check it with the micrometer. So we'll come down and check the far end, lock the micrometer, and we are about 934 thou. We'll check the other end. And we're very close to the same size. This may have to be repeated a couple of times until you get that tailstock in alignment, but hopefully it will help save some of the grief you're getting from turning tapers. Another way of doing the same thing, if you have access to it, is a parallel test bar. And that's what this is here. So it's ground and hardened. It has a center in both ends. You want to make sure that it's straight before you start, and check the diameter in several spots just to make sure it is a parallel test bar and it's not a mandrel. What I did is I put this in a V block and I ran a dial indicator over it in several spots, making sure that it was coming back to the same zero. So I've taken the chuck off of the lathe and I'm just going to insert a center into the headstock. So I've cleaned the outside, the center, and the bore, and I'm just going to snap it in. Now what I'll do is I will make sure the centers are clean and the centers are good that I have installed in the lathe, and we'll just set this parallel test bar up, making sure the tailstock is locked in place. And now what we can do is we can run a dial indicator down its length and we can check it that way. Everything's nice and tight. Okay, I'm just going to move the camera back a little bit, and I have shifted it off of center again. So we'll see how far it's out, and it's not too bad. Okay, so I'm going to set it at zero at the headstock, and we'll come down and we will check the tailstock. I'm hoping you can see that on that dial indicator. And we'll come down and check the tailstock. So it's actually falling about 3 thou. So what we're saying is the tailstock is sitting about 3 thou further away from us. So we need to again put a dial indicator on the tailstock and bring it back half of that measurement, or 1.5 thou. This is a really nice tool to have in your toolbox, so you can do things such as checking the center in the tailstock on your lathe.